4.6 litres per 100 kilometres on the highway, and it is not a hybrid. On this edition of Test Drive, the Chevrolet Cruze Eco.
According to General Motors, the Chevrolet Cruze is a product of global proportions. The car was styled and engineered by Daewoo and Opel. It rides on the General's Global Delta platform. For many, the Daewoo connection could be considered a negative. The reality is it has little effect on how the Cruze performs, or more importantly, how it should be perceived. It is a decidedly decent compact car that's packed with leading-edge technology.
Cruze's cabin has been well thought through. For instance, the fabric in the middle of the seats is picked up on the dash and the door panels. It adds a richness that you don't expect at this end of the marketplace. You'll also find all of the toys with but one omission, Bluetooth. It is wrapped up in the connectivity package and it will cost you $745. The problem? Well, with more and more jurisdictions introducing hands-free legislation, it should be standard. It most certainly is on some of the Cruze's key competitors.
The Eco model is based on the regular Cruze LT Turbo, meaning it earns the same fuel-efficient 1.4-litre turbocharged four-cylinder engine. This motor delivers the best of both worlds. It boasts segment-busting fuel economy, yet when pushed, the blown mill delivers 138 horsepower and, more importantly, 148 pound-feet of torque at a low 1850 RPM. These numbers deliver on the promise of performance. The Eco hustles to 100k in under 10 seconds, and it completes the more important 80 to 120 passing move in 7.4 seconds.
The changes to the Eco model are subtle, but they do make a big difference. When it comes to the aerodynamics, there's less open area in the grille, and the underbumper opening actually has powered louvers. They open and shut depending upon the vehicle speed. These, a few other tricks, and you actually drop the drag by 10%. This vehicle is also 100 kilograms lighter than the donor vehicle, the LT Turbo. Among other things, lightweight wheels and low profile tires. And if you go with the manual, 3 of the 6 speeds are actually overdrives. That's how they get down to 4.6 liters per 100 kilometers on the highway. If you go with this car, which is the automatic version, it's still exceptionally good at 5.1 liters per 100 kilometers.
While the stock transmission is the slick-shifting 6-speed manual, the Eco Tester arrived with the optional 6-speed manumatic. It works well with the engines as the ratios bring good off-the-line performance and relaxed highway cruising. However, there is an annoying anomaly. The transmission tends to get a little sluggish when shifting through its gears occasionally. The moral of the story? Stick with the manual and the better fuel economy it delivers.
As a full-on four-door family sedan, the Cruze works. There's plenty of leg space, plenty of head space. You get 60-40 split folding rear seat backs, and behind that, 15 cubic feet of cargo space. The lone drawback? Hockey stick style hinges.
Where the Cruze really makes a statement is the manner in which it handles. Its European heritage shines through in a very impressive manner. In fact, the driving feel is one of substance and control. On one hand, the suspension takes the sting out of a rough road, which delivers the demanded comfort. Conversely, there's very little body roll through a fast corner, and even less pitch and dive under hard acceleration or braking. Likewise, the steering feel is excellent. It's light at low speeds and firms up nicely at higher speeds. In this regard, the Cruze sets a high standard for the class.
Since its introduction, the Cruze has been popular. The introduction of the Eco model should boost that popularity, and for one important reason. If you look at the average car, it is darn near impossible to attain the highway figure that's posted with that vehicle. With this car, well, you can actually get 4.6 litres per 100 kilometres. I did over a 100k highway run. It all goes to show that it actually works.